This device here is going to revolutionize the way that you connect HDMI video sources to your productions. Now, whether you're bringing an HDMI video source in from a mirrorless or a DSLR camera, or maybe an HDMI video source from a laptop because you're looking to share your screen inside of your production, you see applications such as eCamm Live can easily bring those video sources into the program feed itself. However, you have to use something that converts that HDMI video signal into something that your software can recognize. Now, most of us use something like an Elgato CamLink 4K or similar, where it's a USB device and your HDMI source connects into that, and then that device converts that signal into a video feed that your software can handle. Now, the thing is, once you start to get to two HDMI video sources and more, that's where things get a little bit hairy. For example, the Elgato CamLink 4K, if you're going to install two or more of them on your computer system, each of those CamLinks must be connected to a different USB bus.
Beep beep.
So not only do you have to use two different USB ports, each of these ports must be in a high bandwidth, high power available port or dock for these devices to work properly. So what's the solution? The solution is to bring in your video from another video source other than the USB connections. So that's where this fancy little box comes in. This is the ZowieTek 4K HDMI Video Encoder and Decoder. So what this tiny box does is it takes your HDMI video signal and then it converts it into different sources. Most importantly for our usage here, this converts it into an NDI signal, which is a video signal that travels over your network. All right, so let's do a quick unboxing and see what's inside of this. Now, this is the generic brown paper box that it comes in, which is actually really quite nice. It doesn't have to be super fancy or anything like that. Now, once we open the box, we get a let's get started card as well as a quick start guide. So we're gonna put that on the side. Now, inside the box comes the device itself, a USB-C charging as well as a data cable. It comes with this little thing that's here. Oh, it's basically a hot shoe adapter with a 1/4-20 thread on the top. So it looks like you can put this on the top of, let's say for example, a camera, and then mount this box to the top. So that's kind of neat. And then the next item here is obviously, this one is the North American adapter. So if you get a different box from a different country, then of course this is going to match that. So that's what we have here. Let's look on one side here. We can have an HDMI input, DC out. This is a 12 volt DC out. This is where we actually connect our LAN connector. So this is a gigabit LAN connector as well as a USB-C port. Now on the other end here, you can have your headphone output, a microphone input. Now those are both 3.5 millimeter connectors, as well as another USB-A port, and then an HDMI out or loop out. So this allows you to bring an HDMI signal in on one connection and then also have real-time zero latency HDMI out. So for example, if this was going to be bringing in a gaming console, you can bring in the signal from one port and then the other one will go to your monitor and it'll have zero latency or zero lag. On one side, you've got an LCD screen, and then on the other side, this little white box. At the beginning, I was like, what is this? There's got to be some sort of a light back there or something. And there is. It's actually a tally light. So when you're using this as an NDI video signal source, when your broadcasting system is using or accessing that NDI signal, this actually should light up, letting the talent know that this is the camera they should be looking at. There are three cables you're going to need to connect here at the very minimum to get an NDI signal over to your computer system. The first is a USB power connection, which comes with this device. However, you can use any, I would say 25 watt or higher power brick with a long extension cord to be able to power this device. You're going to need an Ethernet cable to make sure that this is connected to the fastest type of connection to your network, because it's not going to work over Wi-Fi. And then the third one is the HDMI video signal itself. So let's go ahead and get that connected. I'm going to connect the HDMI video signal first. Then the next one will be the Ethernet cable. And last but not least, we're gonna connect the USB cable. All right, I can tell right off the bat, the back is actually lit up now, so it's powered on. And the front here, you can see now, if I just change the exposure a bit, now the front is booting up. Now this device does take maybe 30 seconds to boot, and that's actually for a good reason, because this is a very powerful computer that's inside of this tiny little box. You see, video encoding is one of the hardest things that any computer system can do, and this little box can do it really, really well. All right, let's log into the web interface of this ZowieBox encoder decoder. So I'm gonna enter the IP address that I see on my screen into my computer browser, and you're going to be able to log in with your default admin username and password. This is the signal that is coming from my Sony ZV-E10 that you can see over here. Now, let's take a look at the speed. So the main camera here is a Sony ZV-E10 that's connected to a Cam Link 4K, which is a USB dongle from Elgato. We're going to go over to the settings tab here and go over to streaming and then NDI. In here is where you can go ahead and rename your box, so the NDI signal that's going to be seen from the other computer systems that can detect NDI signals. However, I'm going to leave that by default here and just simply go to enable and save. Now, as you can see, the modification is successful. However, I do have to restart this box. So in order to do that, I'm going to go over to system on the default tab and hit restart. Now, from here, as this system is restarting, you could see that the box is really not really saying very much, except encoder now has NDI HX beside it. And while it's doing its thing, I'm gonna hear the fan go off and then everything's gonna restart. So 3, 2, 1, let's see. There it goes. So now the box is rebooting by itself. And again, it's going to take about 15 to 30 seconds to do that. While it's rebooting, I'm just going to wait for this signal to show up inside of my eCamm Live. And once that happens, I'll be able to bring that in and do a side-by-side comparison to show you exactly how fast this signal can be. Now, I'm going to go back here and I'm going to log in to the web interface. I'm going to see if it's available yet. Okay, it is. So it's still booting up. It hasn't finished yet, but you can see here that it's waiting for a signal, and there's the new signal. The NDI signal is going to be enabled in a couple of seconds, but you can still see just how fast it is. Now let's go over to eCamm Live. You guys can see that this is how I'm running my eCamm Live software, and you can see that there is an NDI signal over here. So I'm gonna go to full screen video, and you can see here, I'm now switched over to the NDI signal. There's really not much of a difference or a delay that's coming from my microphone to this video signal. Now, if I add them side by side, so if I go here and then I add this one side by side, I'm not gonna look between the middle of the two cameras, so you can't really tell which one I'm looking at, but the one on the right side of your screen is going to be the NDI signal coming from the ZowieBox, and the one on the left side of your screen is the one that's coming from my Cam Link 4K. Now, I have not done color adjustments with the NDI video signal version of this. However, if you're looking at the two, the speed is very, very close. It might be not even maybe one frame off, but you can see that it's a very, very fast signal that's coming in. And overall, it's much more sharp, so I have to make some adjustments on the camera. But overall, this is how fast and easy this signal can be. Now, again, what this does is it reduces the need for you to install several different USB HDMI capture devices on your computer system. As mentioned before, when you do two or more, you start to complicate a lot of things on your computer system itself. However, you can have a significant amount more of NDI video signals coming across the network and into your computer system. Because the key is, as you're creating content, the more complex your setup is, your role and responsibility as a creator is to reduce the amount of resources that your computer is going through. And USB devices, they increase the amount of resources your computer is having to use just to make all those connections work. But when you have multiple NDI signals, you can bring them quickly and easily over the network with very little resource usage on your main machine. Now, if you are interested in learning more about the software that I was using called eCamm Live, then I want you to go over ahead and click on this thumbnail here, because this is a playlist that's gonna show you how to use eCamm Live, all the buttons and the interfaces and the menus, and really it's gonna show you exactly how you can get started on your own. Make sure to check the link in the description for a discount on your first purchase.